Hey, so today I've got another interesting one for you. Today we're going to be looking at Castle's Chit Barley Flakes. Very interesting product.
Being the oldest malting plant in Belgium means we make a lot of different kinds of malt, which is fantastic for making award-winning beers. However, sometimes brewers still have a hard time understanding how they are to be used. Don't worry, we've got you covered. In this series, we show you how to use each and every single one of all of our malts.
So, as you can see next to me over here, today we're talking about Château Barley Chit Flakes. What is a chit flake? So, a chit flake is pretty much a grain of barley that has just barely been malted and then rolled flat with a hot roller. Why would you do this? Because if your brewery is not capable of using normal raw grains, then this is what you'd actually opt for, because it's much, much easier to work with. If you can see this one, the labeling is in light green, which also denotes that this is one of our organic range. So for more information on organic versus standard, please refer to our video on the same. Anyway, let's get started and see what this is all about.
Castle Malting barley chits are made by very briefly germinating two-row spring barley, but only long enough to degrade proteins and beta-glucans to make this an easier ingredient to work with as compared to pure unmalted barley. We then use hot rollers to flatten the grains, with the result being an ingredient that performs like an adjunct in the beer, yet is neutral in flavor when used in barley-based beers.
Alors, les flocons d'orge sont importants aussi pour amener des protéines. Alors, les protéines sont importantes bien sûr pour le trouble, mais aussi pour la mousse. Et donc, ces flocons qui ont été traités à la vapeur, donc déjà empesés, peuvent être utilisés directement à l'empattage et améliorer justement le trouble s'il est désiré et la mousse si nécessaire.
Belgian beers, Belgian blonde. Here we are taking a beer that usually uses brewer's syrup to lighten the body, but instead using barley chits as a way to omit the flavor associated with sugars in beer. Simply substitute the 10% sugar syrup with 20% barley chit flakes. It's as simple as that. British beers. Irish dry stout. The dry characteristic in this style of beer is due to the high level of attenuation that comes from the use of 40% unmalted barley adjuncts. One of the reasons Guinness stout is so popular is similarly due to the delightful roast notes it sports, combined with infinite drinkability that they achieve through this very method to this day, used between 20 and 40% of the grist. English style barley wine. A big heavy beer in most brewing books. The trouble is both with attenuation and balancing out the sweetness with a firm hop bitterness. By adding barley chit, you thin out the body and ensure a drier finish, which is good as you then don't need to rely so heavily on the hops for balance. Use about 20% in the recipe. German beers. German Helles, probably not a Helles in the traditional sense, but one of the hardest parts of brewing this beer is to get it to attenuate properly, while at the same time retaining enough body, mouthfeel, and just a touch of sweetness to round out the style. All this using mostly Pilsen malt. One way around it is to increase the saccharification temperature for sweetness and mouthfeel, and then add a little Castle chit malt to ensure overall impression is a beer you can drink gallons of. Experiment with values between 8 and 15%. American beers. American lager. A beer style synonymous with the word adjunct, let's see if we can improve upon this meta. Instead of using the usual rice or corn, adding barley chits will give us all the properties that are usually added through the use of other adjuncts, except we keep the flavor of a pure barley beer. Add up to 40% of the fermentables.